You stick the point of your dagger in, you draw it around. Nothing like happens on the surface other than the ripples you expect. As you draw it out, you notice that some of the blood seems to cling to, let's say, the first inch of your dagger that you dipped into the blood.
Could I wipe it on the edge of the well?
Yeah, you can. It doesn't, even though you wipe it, it seems to almost have stained the metal. And as you watch, you can slowly see the blood seeping out, like whatever this stain is cleaning itself. It looks almost like it absorbed something from the blood that only lasts a short amount of time. As you see, like 15 seconds, 30 seconds go by as you're looking at it, it looks about half the size, and after a minute, all the blood seems to have drained off of the end of your dagger.
So it's an extra thick, sticky blood?
Hard to say.
That's pretty fucking weird.
Would anyone like to make me some kind of arcana?
I can try.
Okay. I'll give Z advantage, because they are actively doing stuff.
Wow. That was shit. Actually.
Okay.
Oh, wait. It's about to be worse. Like shit. Hell
yeah. It's been great.
Okay. Ralzon, it might be magic. It's possible. Mm. It's probably something that is affecting your weapon. These undead seem to avoid it, so maybe this blood can hurt undead? Maybe dipping your stuff in it helps it, or it hurts it? It's hard to say. It might just be bad, because they were avoiding it.
Someone drink it.
Look at everybody and just point at the knife like, what the fuck was that? Did y'all see that? This?
Yeah, that was pretty funky. Should we dip? I don't know.
These look like the vampire in this vampire server vampire. This coffin in here.
Yeah.
It's so coffin-y.
You saw that's where the lady vampire spawn came out from.
Yes.
Oh, Karshi gets the fancy one.
Was the coffin like empty? Wait a minute.
Is this door open?
There's yep, a lot of all coffins. The doors open.
Oh, I don't like this.
I mean, I'll check it around for gold and stuff.
Sure, give me an investigation. It's hard to say. The thick storm clouds above your head obscure any light. You know you've been here for a couple hours and you got here in the early morning, but it's darker than night outside.
It's darker than night and it's only been a couple hours since the early morning when we walked in here. That's kind of scary. Mm.
You'll never see the daylight again.
Seriously.
With a 15 investigation, Geraldine, you search around, you find old and crusty clothes that look like they haven't been worn in many years. Ample spider webs. But nothing of note or value in any of these chambers. Ralzon, you go through and find much of the same. Some of the clothing in the vampire spawn's rooms are a little bit more supple, like they've been worn recently or were acquired more recently. You see clothing with styles going back about a century, maybe.
Well, they've been here and I've had it for a while. Suppose we should head down and see where this trickle effect is going.
I have that red cable.
Question, is any of the trunks or the coffins sitting open?
The ones Geraldine and Ralzon have basically gone through and opened up all the chests and searched them. Nobody's been searching the coffins, specifically, unless anybody wanted to do that, their role, but nobody mentioned it to me.
Chicken foot lockers.
Yeah, if you would like to start opening the coffins, Z, we could absolutely do that.
Yeah, open the coffin.
Ooh, get to it.
Don't be afraid.
Fuck it. I will.
Okay, you walk over, you open the lid of the coffin.
Yeah, I'm gonna like crack it open with my dagger and lift it up. Is there anything in there?
There's a loud
fire bolt, just in case.
What?
That's funny.
I'm readying a firebolt just in case. Just to go over her head in case anything goes wrong.
Sure.
Sets her hair.
Yeah. You crack open the coffin, it slides to the side of the coffin and against the wall with a loud clack and then a thunk as it hits the ground. It is filled with dirt and small stones. It appears loamy, but also very dry.
You mean stones like gems or stones like rock?
Like rocks.
Oh. I can do an investigate?
Yes, you can. If you want to dig through the dirt.
I'm going to use my dagger to poke around in there. Oh, wow. I don't see shit.
Yeah. You're really worried about, like, razor blades in the dirt, so you, like, poke around to the top, but a dagger isn't a very good digging tool, so you kind of just, like, sand garden the top of the dirt and go, that's better, at least. You draw, like, a little design in waves and stuff like that. It's pretty. You kind of lost the thread a little bit.
A little bit.
Can I open up this one?
Absolutely.
To be clear, this trunk has already been opened by
yes.
Me?
Okay. Yes. Geraldine, you go through. It appears to be a coffin filled with dirt. There's enough space that a medium creature could like lay on top of the dirt or partially buried and have the lid close on them with a few inches of clearance.
The dirt's supposed to go like around the grave, not like in. Why is the dirt in it?
Mighty sus. Okay. Shall we just keep going?
I think so. Doesn't seem like they kept any treasures in here.
Right behind you.
Skedaddle.
Why don't you all stack up on the stairs for me? Geraldine, I cleared you a spot. Here, I'm gonna arrange y'all right here. Okay. As you move down the stairs, you see that here multiple hammocks are hanging between wooden beams. What should have been dozens upon dozens of men are just empty hammocks.
Don't trust that.
Your gaze, as you're coming down, catches a glint of something in the corner of your vision. And as you turn, you see a horrendous creature feasting on the entrails of an agonized soldier. As life leaves him, you see another skull appear atop the creature's back where dozens are stitched, stuck in a grim smile. As the monster turns towards you and leaps, please everybody, roll initiative.
The fuck?
Roll game initiative.
You got this, Temperance.
I do apparently take requests for music now, also.
What?
In my other game, I've started taking requests for music. People will just send me links for the songs that they want and watch together.
Interesting.
So if anybody has any
music requests. Can we get the Final Fantasy X victory song for every time we beat a monster?
I need a link, please, but yes.
Okay.
Final Fantasy fanfare.
Hold on.
The way they literally, that's this, I played this game that was like a JRPG set in one of the Harry Potter games. I think it was Prisoner of Azkaban. And that was the noise that played when you finished the battle also. They literally just copied the music.
It works.
All right. As you turn, the creature and a pair of ghostly pirates come surging towards you. From around the side comes a sprinting pirate who turns and will attack Jerilyn with his scimitar. A 14 versus your AC, Jerilyn.
That will miss.
Alright.
As he gets there, I'm going to reactionary pole arm strike him.
Okay. Fourteen is going to hit.
Thank fuck.
Oh. No spirit shroud,
yeah,
right?
I was gonna say, yeah, ignore that. That okay. Should be well worn off by now because we're investigating.
Okay. Then with a slash, you cut into him, but he is ghostly and not yet. Excuse me. Not yet harmed enough to be stopped. You hear what sounds like galloping to your north as this massive, massive creature comes barreling down towards you and hits Temper like a truck. As it is running, it makes two throws, it reaching back onto its back with these horrible double-jointed elbows, and as it runs, it lifts and throws a skull, one at Temper and one at Ralzon. A 9 will miss you, Temper, and a 5 will miss you, Ralzon. But as it lands in front of you, you see this thing's maw grow wide, and a glowing skull appear in each of its eyes as it reaches towards you, not your physical form, but your soul. A 20 to hit you, Temper.
I'm going to cast shield as a reaction, bringing my AC up to 24.
Fuck yeah. Okay, that bounces off this like massive maw of necrotic energy is stopped by your wall of magic, and it claws against it. Jerilyn, there's a pirate behind you.
Yes, there's a pirate behind me. I'm going to turn to that pirate and give it a good old slashy slap. My rapier.
Okay. Please do so. A 26 is definitely going to slashy slash. Four, five piercing. All right.
And then I'm an extra attack.
Okay.
Okay.
For 20, that'll also hit. For six more piercing. Where's that look?
Just a... like a straight up, just like an X slash formation, and he kills. That's how he kills it. Very quick and easy.
Okay. Is that you?
Yes, that's me.
Z.
Yo. Okay. So, can I ask how big this thing is in comparison to me?
It is a large creature, so you're occupying a 5x5 cube, it's occupying a 10x10 cube. You're also short for, imagine a grizzly bear, but bigger, with skulls covering its entire back like a frog's eggs. And it's got like a horrible skull though, face. Right? Huh? Yes.
Like, okay. All right. I think I'm gonna walk up to it and try to punch it.
All right.
And see if that... Actually, would I be able to get past him to flank him?
You would need to move through his space at double movement. I think you have just enough movement to do that, yes.
Okay, so I'll do that.
It'll take your whole movement to get there, though.
I'm gonna attack him from behind.
Okay, with advantage.
Okay. Windabar. I'm gonna do one of those.
Yeah, 26 is definitely gonna hit.
Wonderful.
For 13 damages.
And then I'm gonna do a second attack.
Is your unarmed strike considered magical at this time?
That's a good question. I feel like you and I had a conversation
yes.
about that.
It's a feat that you get. It's called Key Empowered Strikes.
Okay.
So that is magical damage.
I'm gonna hit it again.
Okay, please do so.
Unarmed.
A 21 is also going to hit.
Okay.
For 7 more bludgeoning.
Could I do a make an unarmed strike one more time as a bonus action?
Yes, you may, as a monk.
Okay.
Good job. 21.
I'm gonna do it one more time.
6 more. Very, very nice.
I'm punching it in his ass, by the way.
Okay.
Kicking beat that booty.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hell yeah, punch it in the ass.
Yeah.
Alright, is that you?
Yes, that is me.
Hell the fuck yeah. We go then next to Lady Temper. Lady Temper, your ally, Z, is over there on the other side of this skull bearer that you saw dead on the, another one dead upstairs in the captain's quarters. Your magical shield fades away.
Okay, technically speaking from this position, would it be considered advantage?
Absolutely.
I was attacking on it? Okay.
Absolutely.
I'm going to wail on this thing twice with my plus one plant slayer.
Okay. A 23 and a 26 are both going to hit.
All right. That's going to be...
Whoa. 33 damage?
All together.
Jesus. This thing looks very, 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 very hurt. It was above bloodied before that strike, and it is now, you smashed half of the skulls on its back, it is leaking necrotic energy from multiple tears, its black fluid-like blood is pooling on the ground, like lakes underneath it. That is massive.
To use my movement, and, I'm gonna, maneuver myself over to the side, so that Geraldine can get in with advantage when their turn comes around.
You're going to have to move to this or this square to be able to stand.
Oh, is that all?
Yeah, because it's occupying these four.
Oh, okay. My bad.
No worries. All right,
cool. Yeah, I just make my way around it and I come up next to Z and sort of flag the other two. It's come on, the water's fine.
Okay. Ralzon, you hear the running feet of another pirate coming towards you. It is your turn, mein friend. What would you like to do?
Seeing that her weapon's probably not going to do much without empowered spells, she's going to throw a secret flame at this nightmarish thing.
This one here? Okay. That is a dex save of a 15, unfortunately.
That'll be me then, because I don't want to toe-to-toe with this thing.
Okay. Whoa, 6, a dash. Rounding the corner with a crossbow bolt raised and pointed, but he doesn't have the time to pull the trigger. This pirate looks and locks eyes with you, Geraldine, even as you're killing his compatriot. Ralzon and Geraldine, there is a rumbling from your south, and as you turn towards the half-open door leading to the chamber behind you, the other slams open as a second skull bearer tears its way out and appears right on top of you. One of its large paws slamming down onto the lowest step of the stairs.
Stab the paw.
Oh, shit.
Than attack, it rears up and you see the skulls on its back and on its side, all of the jaws open and flames begin to pour out and pooling on the ground for 10 feet around it. Geraldine and Ralzon, I need dexterity saving throws versus fire damage.
15.
Okay, both of you are gonna succeed, so you will take half. So that is only 9 fire damage. That guy's dead. This skull bearer is going to turn around and see the two people in front of it. And the small one punched it, so it's going to make two claw attacks at her. A 12 and a 14 to hit you, Z. You're muted. Rain appears to be having a conversation.
It's the small one.
Alright, Temper, I'll do a soul tear against you. Oh.
Thing.
A 12 or a 14 to hit you, Z? Is this thing claws at you? Nope. Alright. And this thing will attempt to tear Temperance's soul once more. That's a 22.
I have to use the spell, but yeah, I'm gonna shield again.
Okay.
Bring me up another to 24.
Shield. Alrighty. Then it is Geraldine's turn.
Okie doke. So I'm gonna. Excuse me. I'm gonna take this will slice at that guy.
Sure. 25 is definitely gonna hit. For 8 damage, bloodying this guy. Massive slash through his ethereal form. Another 25 is gonna hit. What is that gonna look like?
This one is a slash and then a stab to the head. And then. I'm gonna. Oh, wait. Did I use it? Oh, I used my action surge already. Then I'm just gonna stand here.
Hey. Alright, you stand there. Z!
I'm gonna do the unarmed strikes again.
Okay, roll them one at a time. 26 is gonna hit. I have a sneaking suspicion. Why don't you tell me what that looks like? You kill that thing.
I'm gonna, this one's gonna be a kick, and I'm going to cross it like against his back leg so that it like loses balance and fall down.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope it cracked his head on the fucking ground.
Absolutely. Splits its skull open, and yeah. Then all the skulls of the back begin to dissolve.
Dissolve?
Okay. Yeah. They seem to turn to steam and begin to wisp away.
Gross. Very gross.
Yep, you're standing next to a line of cells. I'm not sure if you take the time to look in them or you aim at the skull bearer to your south.
Oh shit, I didn't even see there was a second one.
Yeah, you turn around after roundhouse kicking that one and you want to run down and fight it?
Oh shit, yeah I do.
Okay.
Could I make it?
I could do that.
I'll come down here.
Okay.
And I'm gonna strike that one.
Make sure you untoggle your advantage.
Okay. At the top.
12 is not going to hit, unfortunately. It is able to dodge out of the way of that one.
Alright, well as it dodges, I'm gonna flip it off.
Okay, you get a bonus action punch.
Yeah, I'm gonna go one more.
So whoop. Another 26 is gonna hit. That is your third crit of the night.
Man, nice. I'm on a roll.
Fucking destroy those motherfuckers.
For 9 more damage. Very nice.
Fuck you skull-bearing monsters.
Hell yeah. Is that you?
Yes, that's my turn.
Okay, Lady Temper. The run back is here. You are muted, Lady Temper. Fuck. Ah, shit. All singing, all dancing, bud.
I'm gonna go get a refill. I'll be right back.
Don't read too much, Phil. Got him.
What'd you just call me?
Phil. I can't believe Phallus is fucking dead. Oh, he's unmuted.
Hello. There we go.
There's the boy. It's your turn. Sorry. The run back is here for you.
Yay. Oh.
Yay. Wondrous. Let's see. How do Ralzon and Z look? Do they look like they're in deep danger?
I mean, this thing is much bigger than both of them. Even Geraldine, as hurt as they look, is probably not doing super well.
Okay, alright, in that case, I'm gonna take the movement. I'm gonna run up and, well, I can't be in its space, but I wanna be...
Back up one.
Yeah. Alright. Yeah, but that's still attacking distance, right? I'm just making sure, because
someday... Yeah, absolutely.
Alright. And I wail on this first. Wail on it with my plus one sword. Oh, actually, no advantage. Sorry about that. So that's
22 and a 9. A 22 is going to hit.
All right.
For 12 magical damages. Slashing into this thing once again with your long sword. Just tempered with the shield first and the magical shield that comes out of it and makes it bigger, and just slashing and hacking around it. I love it. Nice ashing on my phone. Good job. Is that you?
That's me.
You ashed on your phone.
Ralzon, it's your turn, girly.
Blanking.
Slay.
Yeah.
Get it? Slay.
Don't feel like my halberd's gonna be much help here, so I'm gonna
Cultural appropriation.
Oh. Sacred Flame.
That was really
cool. That is a 5 from the Skull Bear.
So nice.
Or 16 radiant damage. Very nice. Wow. Oh, it's 9. Oh,
it's 9. Well, I accidentally clicked it twice.
That's fine. It is still bloodied by that damage.
And that was me.
Alright, this pirate is dead. It is this Skull Bear's turn. Rather than attack, once again, all the creatures in front of it must make a dexterity saving throw versus fire damage as it stands, and fire once again begins to pool all around it. Everybody make me a dex save. Man, and I really wanted to tear somebody's soul out. Okay, a 7 from Geralyn, a 4 from Tempera, a 5 from Ralzon.
God, there's no fucking way I can even save that.
I need, I need a dex save. Brain! Do monks get evasion yet?
I was trying to see if there was something I could use.
I think monks get evasion is 7th level. Wow. Alright. So everyone's gonna fail. Mm-hmm. That's going to be 17 fire damage for everyone. You're resistant, Ralzon, so that's...
Am I?
Aren't you? Tieflings?
How many...
Tiefling! I'm a hobgoblin!
Oh, I'm sorry. I see the red skin. I'm sorry. I'm racist.
Racist piece of shit.
Hey, I'm a tiefling.
You're a tiefling. Temper's a tiefling. Temper's gonna take...
half damage.
You take 8 instead. 17. 17.
I assume the DC's 13. Throwing shit.
It's hard to say what the DC's gonna be.
You know. Can't even use it.
Alright. Now that that's done, Geralyn! Oh, please make sure you take your 17 damage also. Just, I want to see them health bars decrease. I want to watch.
Okay, so. I'm just gonna slash at this guy. Let's fucking get him.
You have advantage. Ralzon is still there. 9's gonna miss, but a 14 will hit. For 10 damage. This thing is very hurt. Below bloodied, you stab through, and more ichor comes just pouring out. Do you longbow and rapier again?
No, the longbow was an accident.
Oh, okay. Where's the what's the third rapier attack from?
No, that I have advantage on the first rapier attack.
Oh, okay. Then a 22 will also hit. My apologies, I was not understanding what was happening. For 8 more piercing damage, very nice. This thing looks like a couple deft strikes would kill it. One or two, like, one more of those first ones that you dealt out would kill it. Is that your turn?
Yes, that's my turn.
Z! Baby, talk to me. Yeah.
Fucking kick it.
Yeah, I bet you are. Oop. A 10's gonna miss, but a 16's gonna hit.
Wunderbar. And
4-5.
I'm gonna kick it one more time.
24's gonna hit.
For 9
what does that look like?
Oh my god. This is gonna be a very, very satisfying crunch as I'm like burying my foot in its face. Down.
Hell yeah. And with that, y'all are out of combat.
Goodbye, monsters.
Yay!
Oh my god.
I didn't know you even saw my message. That just gave me so much joy. That's so gratifying. Thank you.
You're welcome. You all have solved my umbral or my skull bearer puzzle. Jerlyn, you step into this room here. It is lit by burning candles that fill two tables set against the north wall. You see a coffin slightly buried in what appears to be dirt that covers and fills more than half of this room. It is like packed against the wall and sloped downwards.
Wow. I'm gonna real quick drink two of my healing potions.
Okay. Wow, a macro for healing potions? I'm in love.
I'm gonna drink three of mine.
Okay. +6
I would like to drink two of them too.
Okay.
What do I have to do for that?
So each healing potion is 2d4+2, so if you're gonna drink two of them, you can roll 4d4+4.
4d4. Holy cow. Wow.
So, 13.
Okay,
perfectly
you.
Average. That's all things
you
should
can
be.
Always also make a macro for it. Neat.
Are you investigating in here, Temper or Geralyn?
Geralyn. Yeah, I wanna investigate this coffin.
Okay. What are you, just looking at the outside of it?
I'm gonna push it open.
Okay, you push the coffin open. Even as you're pushing it open, you can see that there is a figure inside this coffin. So you continue and push the coffin off, the lid sliding over onto the side, and you see an emaciated form, pale white, long, claw-like nails at the ends of its fingers, huge fangs jutting out over its bottom lip. This thing is naked and completely hairless. You can see that its eyes are much too big for it to be a human creature, and its ears are pointed. It is also staked through the heart with a stake of wood more than a foot long.
Sorry, go ahead.
There is also, on the side of the coffin, you can see what appears to be a notebook with many tabs sticking out from it, and a pen, or a pencil slipped into the rings on the side. What were you going to ask, Temper?
Does the body, despite having the stake through it, does the body look preserved? Does it look withered, or does it look whole, but maybe just held in place because the stake is through its heart?
It's hard to tell. It does look withered and emaciated, but also you don't see like the skin is intact all the way around, and though it's tight against the muscles and layers of skin underneath it, it is tight against muscles and organs that are still mostly whole from what you can see. Like the place where the stake is driven through is not an open gaping wound. It seems as if the body is whole except for this stake driven through it, though it does look old in a way that's hard to describe, like the skin would crack like old paper if it moved.
Could I run over and push Geralyn a little bit away from it and block Catherine, like, don't be stupid. Don't touch it anymore. Yeah. Just chicken my head.
You know, that's fair.
Block Geralyn. Don't touch it. As a matter of fact, can I reach behind me and close it?
You can, but I think the other people want to investigate it.
Well, Tempo was just offering her a bottle of lantern oil. Just, you know, we could burn it.
Z is going to nod violently.
Alright. I knew I'd
burn the witch.
These for a reason. Ralzon's going to take out an alchemist fire.
Okay.
She's going to uncork that shit and pour it all over the body.
Okay, you leaving the writings and the notes in there?
Yeah, wait. Grab it.
No, I mean...
She's actively pouring it on the feet, I'll say. Yeah. And
okay,
like,
wait. Yeah.
Grab that shit. Go.
Walk.
Go. Shove. Shove.
Grab it.
Like, don't do it.
I mean, it's already...
High or low to stop Ralzon in time.
Forever high.
High. Roll me a d20.
Okay. Fuck.
Yep.
You reach out to stop Ralzon and you actually bump the bottom of the vial and tip her hand into as it starts to pour. You have one chance if you want to try and grab the notes. If not, you can try and do something else.
Grab the notes.
I absolutely want to grab them.
Okay, I'll let you roll sleight of hand to do so. It's
okay.
A dexterity skill. You're a monk. Okay, yeah, with the 17, you
okay.
Go, and then you reach in really quick and grab it, and pulling it out, there's, like, a fleck of the alchemist fire that, like, goes towards you, and you, like, lower the book a fraction as you're whipping it out so that it's, it just misses it and doesn't stick to the cover. Ralzon, you finish pouring in, drop the vial in, and it shatters, and you can see the flames burn a little bit higher for a moment after that. They coat the body of this creature, and you see alchemist fire begin to burn. I believe it lasts for a minute until it's put out, so you will watch as green, ravenous, uncaring fire burns not only the creature's corpse, not only the stake, but the stone coffin around it begins to melt and soften under the torrent of these green flames that seem to not care as they consume all the resources around them, basically snuffing themselves out by removing anything, even the oxygen. As you are standing close, it gets hard to breathe for this minute, until even this smokeless fire goes out, and you see a singed corpse of basically just bones and a few tattered strips of skin laying in the bottom of this melted pool of rapidly cooling magma.
Z's gonna shake her head really disappointed. Like, we didn't even know the situation. And we just killed them. They could have been a good guy. Obviously, I'm thinking this for myself, but... Shaking my head.
Yes.
Does that mean you open the notes?
Definitely gonna trust a corpse near a bunch of hellfire dogs.
Open it.
Do I know how to read? Is this in common?
It actually appears, it does appear to be in common, but as you read the first word, it's a nonsense word, it doesn't appear to make sense, and as you scan the rest of the page, this is clearly a cipher of some kind that it is written in. Would you please make me an arcana check to try and understand it?
Fuck. Okay. 16?
That is a valiant try, but unfortunately, though you get part of the way working through the cipher, you can't figure out the true substitution. It doesn't seem to be working the way you expected it to.
Would history or religion, understandings, help me to understand the cipher at all?
No, this is clearly some kind of magical formula or process.
Right.
Talking about some kind of arcane system.
Hold it out to everybody facing them and point, like, confused, like, what the fuck? What do we do with this? Help.
You can't read it.
He's gonna nod, like, yeah, I could read it. But not this. And she's gonna shove it closer to your face so you can read it.
You flip the book at Jerilyn. Jerilyn, why don't you make me an arcana check? You take the book, you open it up, you go, whoa.
Fuck.
Jared Lynn, with an 18, you see the notes that Z had made on the cipher, the like small piece of, on a small piece of paper, and you go, oh, well, Z made a mistake right here, and you cross it out and finish drawing out the cipher, and then you're able to read these notes, and so you can rub it all in Z's face as you tell them that these notes explain that this is an elder vampire that has been dead for a long time and is an ancient rival of Captain Catacomb. The captain is trying to use its blood to create thralls that will obey him and only him, as he himself is not yet a powerful enough vampire. The captain is also creating skull bearers from the elder vampire's flesh to kill and capture innocents that have purer blood and that are easier to work with.
Well then.
Well, yeah. So that's all that on there. That's my shorthand way of saying I tell everybody that.
Also, I feel very relieved if he's not strong enough yet.
Yeah, I mean, he's clearly not a threat anymore.
Well, that was the Elder.
Is there anything else in the coffin?
Not anymore. No.
No.
Ain't shit no more. You poured alchemist fire on it. I don't mean to be mean.
So there's no bones, no nothing?
There are charcoal-y nubs that resemble bones. But they're smaller.
Okay.
And a lot of them, there aren't enough that you would say that that's a skeleton. Like, the skull, where you probably poured quite a bit, and the sternum and the, like, legs are basically completely gone.
If y'all didn't get all involved, everything wouldn't be burnt to a crisp.
I don't know. I feel like I did the right thing.
Geraldine starts making gestures to Z, purposefully not saying anything.
Alright, so Z's gonna leave the room.
Okay.
So I guess that means that well of blood and all these creatures were made by this creature we just killed, right?
Well, that's the sleeping one from the notes that you have.
Z, as you walk out here and you say that, you look over towards the jail cells. And in the cells are cadavers. Catheters are inserted into their arms, and what was once an abundant flow of blood is now reduced to a minimal drip coming out from these catheters into small bowls in most of the rooms. Life has long left these bodies, and all the tubes seem to go upwards towards something. And as you look up, you see a blocked off grate. Same as in the floor in the room above you. Most likely the blood from the pool of blood upstairs.
I'm on the wrong side where the doors are not, right? Let me move to the other side.
Yeah.
So there's nobody actually in the room, right?
They're just cadavers, yeah. Like, right. long dead corpses.
Right, okay. I don't sense anybody moving or anything. It's...
No.
Can I walk in? Is it locked?
Yeah, it's locked. They're iron cells.
No. He's gonna look at Ralph and
old,
wait,
rolled
up,
steel.
Like, where the IVs are going up to.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'll go double check. I think it's the blood well. I'll go check out the previously vampire-avoided blood well.
Yeah, you can now see what you originally took to be one of the streams of blood. If you guys want to go back upstairs, I'll take you. You see this here, which you originally thought were like streams of blood. Now you look more closely, they're actually tubes containing blood being siphoned away from this pool here.
Gross.
That's some fat
shit. Probably the process that he was using to try and create the thralls. Which is strange because they seem to avoid that blood. So, what's he doing?
HIV blood.
Jesus fucking Christ. can I do anything down in this pit?
You can. Every once in a while, there's the call of a bird. Why don't you roll me a nature?
Could I do the same?
You are up an entire floor and not anywhere near where that piece is happening. You can't identify it. It sounds like...
It sounds like...
Not an ornithologist. Oh my god, pirates and birds, obviously. Okay. I think the big pirate is downstairs.
You also see a pair of doors here. Ralzon and Z, are you good? Are you done